Hi dear children, how are you all? Hope you all are well and safe. Today, we are going to start a new lesson. The name of lesson is Nonmetals. Look at here children. Is it quite interesting to see the balloons flying up in the air? Good, isn't it? Which is the gas used in these balloons? Yes, helium. Not only helium, but hydrogen is also used. Which are the nonmetals familiar to you? Well, shall we see some more examples of nonmetals? But you need to find out what they are. Ready? See this. Which gas is mainly filled in cylinders used in hospitals for artificial respiration? Absolutely, it is oxygen. Without oxygen, we cannot survive, right? See the next one. Which is the gas filled in tires to increase their efficiency? Yes, it is nitrogen. Hope you have seen this tire inflator at petrol pump, right? And which is the gas liberated when bleaching powder reacts with water? Of course, it is chlorine. So all these examples we saw are nonmetals, right? So dear children, now do you understand the importance of compounds of nonmetals in our daily life activities? So we are going to start a new lesson. In this lesson, we will discuss about the important nonmetals, its uses, preparation, etc. Dear children, the number of nonmetals in nature is less than compared to metals. However, the nonmetals and their compounds play a vital role in sustaining our lives. Let us see the importance through some examples. First of all, let us analyze the figure showing the gases contained in the atmospheric air. See, 78% of nitrogen constitute the atmospheric air. What does it mean? Nitrogen is the most abundant element present in the atmosphere. What about the percentage composition of oxygen? It is about 21%, right? So oxygen is the second most abundant gas present in the atmospheric air. Gases like argon, carbon dioxide, etc. are present only in rare quantities. Shall we examine the elements present in the food materials? See, carbohydrate. Carbohydrate is one of the source of energy that constitute the elements such as carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Protein, known as bodybuilding block, contains the elements such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. Fat, another source of energy, contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Now let's examine the elements present in plastics. Have you heard of PVC? PVC, polyvinyl chloride, one of the plastic that contain the elements carbon, hydrogen and chlorine. Polyethylene, otherwise known as polyethene, contain the elements such as carbon and hydrogen. So in all these examples you can see that the elements carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine, etc. are nonmetals. Let us familiarize the nonmetal hydrogen. Hydrogen is a chemical element with the symbol H and atomic number 1. It is one of the lightest element in the periodic table. Do you know the major component present in sun and star is hydrogen? It is present only in very small quantity in free state. Most of the hydrogen on Earth exists in molecular form such as water or organic compound. It is a colorless, odorless, combustible gas with the molecular formula H2. Now let us know about the discovery of hydrogen. Hydrogen was first artificially produced in the early 16th century by the reaction of acids on metals. In 1766, Henry Cavendish discovered the gas hydrogen. He called it as the inflammable air. The name hydrogen is derived from the word hydrogens, which means something that produces water. Now, shall we see the preparation of hydrogen? You all know that acids react with reactive metals and form hydrogen gas. A little amount of dilute hydrochloric acid is added in a test tube containing zinc granules. What do you observe? Did you see the colorless hydrogen gas? If you show a burning splinter to the mouth of a test tube containing hydrogen, the gas will burns with a pop sound. The equation for this chemical reaction can be written as Zn plus 2HCl gives ZnCl2 plus H2. What are the reactants and product in this reaction? You know that zinc and hydrochloric acid are the reactants, whereas the zinc chloride and hydrogen are the products. But how is the zinc chloride formed along with hydrogen? During this chemical reaction, the zinc atom will replace the hydrogen from hydrochloric acid and forms zinc chloride. This type of reactions are called displacement reactions or substitution reaction. So what are displacement reactions? The reactions where an element in a compound is displaced by another element is called displacement reaction or substitution reaction. The reactions between the metals and dilute acids are examples of displacement reactions. Some other examples for the displacement reactions are given in your textbook. So children, try to find out more examples for this type of reactions.